Yes, villagers. In this episode, we're going to be talking about four reasons that you should consider if you think that voting is not important or some type of scam. If you're new to this channel, welcome to our village. If you're a returning villager, welcome as well. So, let's get into it. Welcome to Garden of the Mind, where we reduce stress, improve our health and fitness, and improve our financial IQ every episode. We must believe more than we see. I can't believe in 2020, there are still some conspiracy theorists who are saying that your vote does not count, or voting is a scam, or it's not important, or so many other reasons for you not to vote. I don't understand it. So we're gonna be talking about four different things for you to consider if you think that is your position, or if you know somebody who needs to see this video, please make sure you share it. Tip number one, what lengths are people going through to fulfill this scam? Well, think about it. Voting was so prized that they wouldn't allow just anybody to do it. Before, they wouldn't allow you to vote if you weren't a landowner. Then they started to allow women to vote. Then they started to allow black people to vote. All of these things were kept away from people. Why do you think that they would do something like that? If it was not important, if they were going to rig the election anyway, why go out of your way to exclude certain people from the vote? Another thing, think about the campaigning that's done. Think about how much money goes into electing one person. Even if that person is not successful, millions and millions of dollars are spent on their ad campaign, especially if they are after the presidential election. They are also going to different places, talking to different audiences, doing all of these different things to get someone's vote. If they're gonna rig the election anyway, why go through such length? Now, there are some times where people go through a lot of lengths in order to cover a conspiracy. However, spending millions and millions of dollars, flying to different places, talking to different people, having ads to get the public to solicit money, you got to think about that. If they're doing all of that, all of those are true things, might as well go through with the reality that this thing really matters. Tip number two, voting allows you to participate in the jury pool. So if you are upset with the failure rate of cops being convicted as a result of murdering people, if you're not on the jury pool, if you ducked out of jury duty, then you may say that you are partly responsible for that. Because if you were on the jury pool, you might have been able to sway the jury to think about things from the vantage point that you see them. The jury may have been able to even look at things a little bit different based on your convictions. So don't discount yourself in voting, because it also opens up the ability for you to participate on a jury and to change society. So that is certainly something that is important. Tip number three, voting is extremely important, especially on the local level. We are able to vote for district leaders, judges, senators, assembly people, congress people, so many different people that we're able to elect. And the closer it is to your neighborhood, the harder it is for there to be a cover-up, because there's too many people who are involved in it. So in order for things to be a scam, especially on a local level, that means there have to be conspirators or people to collude a story that is in fact not factual. That's a lot of people that you have to include to make sure that no one tells the truth. If there are so many people who you are confiding in, somebody is going to say something, somebody's going to do something that's going to let the cat out the bag. The more people you tell of a secret, the less of a secret it becomes. So if you're talking about all of these people on the ground level trying to keep a secret, just not going to really work. So you have your elected officials. these local people in government are people that you need to know in order to bring about the change that you are looking for in your community. You have the city council who has a discretionary fund and are able to fund various initiatives. I'm probably going to be doing some shows later on to explain exactly what you can expect from each position. But all of these people rely on your vote. Once again, they all go campaigning, talking to people, going to places that they might not have gone had they not been elected. Why do you think that's done? Your vote really counts. So you really need to see that. Tip number four, there are great lengths that are pursued to make sure that your vote does count and that there is a fidelity involved in the whole electoral process. The Board of Elections allows independent observers, among some of the small ways that they open things up to increase transparency and to increase the fidelity of your vote. That's just one of the things that are done. Now, there are so many other things that they do to make sure that your vote gets noted down accurately. Is it a perfect process? No, it's not. Are there opportunities for growth? Absolutely. Is it a scam? I don't think so. Now, certainly as a society, I believe that the government has merited our distrust by some of the things that it's done in the past. However, I think that there are way too many points for the ball to be dropped for the elections to be rigged. As long as you involve humans in anything, there's going to be points where there's going to be some conspiracy, and there's going to be some points where accidents are going to happen. That just comes with the territory. But do we say that the whole thing is a scam because there are a few corrupt people over here? Or the whole system is questionable because some questionable things have happened over here? There's going to be points of dispute and there's going to be points of imperfection. But I think the biggest mistake that's made is for you to not engage in the process and for you to sit outside of the process and criticize what goes on in the process. If you really believe that the system is corrupt and that a conspiracy is going on, join the system. Show me exactly where. Create an outlet for you to show the world how this is the situation. If you care about the people who you love who are voting and you're allowing them to take part in a system that is corrupt, then it could be said that you might be a part of the problem too. Unless you're doing something to show everyone exactly how the system is as you say it is. If you like this video, please give it the thumbs up. If you like this channel, please subscribe. If you want to know when I post, which is Wednesdays, please click on that notification bell so when you click it, you get a ding on your phone and you know that a new video has been created. And remember, thoughts are actions, words have power, and actions have consequences. I'll see you next Wednesday. I'll see you then.